Hello, I hope you are doing well and you're staying healthy. Today we'll be talking about the dangers of emotional confrontation and how to argue effectively. This is relevant to all of us because not one other person is exactly like you out there. I think we can all agree not one person will have the same upbringing, the same background, and the same belief systems. So because of that, it is inevitable to have differing views from another person. And whatever that difference is in views is called to you, call it a disagreement, a conflict, or a confrontation, we will come across people that don't have the same views as us. And the way that we communicate those views to either get our point across or get a better understanding of where another person is coming from is crucial in everyday life and a skill you need to know to have successful relationships. And the best way to do this, hands down, is to not have it such an emotionally charged event. We do not want an emotional confrontation. In order for you to be fair to yourself and everyone involved or the other person involved, so that you can have peace of mind and that this relationship isn't filled with passive aggressiveness, we need to be able to communicate our differences with kindness and empathy. So here's the situation that we are going to use as an example. Say that you and your partner are working very hard during this period of time where you both are working towards a goal, whether it's a promotion, a new job, maybe the six-pack bod for the summer bod coming up, or maybe money for a down payment of a home. And you two have barely made time for the relationship over the past months. And you're starting to feel neglected, but every time that you reach out for time to spend with each other or for some physical touch, if you know what I mean, you get shut down. Your partner keeps telling you, "I'm sorry, I can't, I really need to focus, I really need to meet this deadline, I really need to meet this goal." And this has been going on for months and you're starting to feel like you're the only one that cares for this relationship. So here is not how to handle it. If they want to ignore you, you go ahead and ignore them back. Two can play at that game. Any attempts for contact, whether physical or or emotional, are met with short and passive comments. And when they ask you what's wrong, you say nothing. Until all the emotions of feeling neglected and uncared for and unthought of, they start to bubble up inside of you and they just explode. You start coming at them with accusations like, "You don't care about me, you don't care about this relationship." This turning into a full-blown argument or emotional confrontation. And your partner is completely blindsided. They're stressed from their work and their constant pursuit of their goals. They call you childish for, you know, blowing up on them all of a sudden with not telling them exactly what was going on in your head. And they shut you out. They walk away and they say they can't deal with this right now. So here is how you effectively confront someone. Number one is you recognize your own needs. You need quality time with your partner. You know that work is busy and that those goals that you two are both working towards, they're both really important. But also remember that your needs for connection are valid and worth communicating. Number two is communicate with your emotions in check. So there are several parts to this. You have to first allow yourself time to respond. So in this moment where you're feeling really flustered over this, not flustered, maybe stressed and sad and annoyed and mad and sad at the same time, you realize you are not in the right state of mind. And maybe your partner's not in the right state of mind because they're also really stressed out about work. So you do something to calm yourself down, whether it's going for a walk, doing some yoga, working out, doing something to calm the mind, calm the emotional self before asking to talk about said issue. And when you start to talk about said issue, make sure that you pay attention to your feelings as you express your words. So in the scenario, you can say, I have been feeling neglected and sad because we have not been spending any time together. And as you're doing this, pay attention to the emotions of the other person as well. Practice empathy here and validate the other person's experience. So after this whole little argument, you can say something like, I know that you probably don't have a lot of time and energy to spare right now, especially with how much you've been working. So I understand why you did not have space to talk about this earlier, especially how I brought it up. I haven't been clear with you before, and I apologize for that. And hopefully, in the best case scenario, your partner would apologize for storming off and calling you childish and not being able to deal with it right then and there. And then you come back to yourself after empathizing, bring that level of awareness back to yourself, and be respectful of yourself as well. You'll say, however, I need quality time and physical touch to feel like I matter to you, to feel like this relationship is a priority. Otherwise, I feel like we might as well be roommates. And the same thing goes back to the person that you're talking to your partner. You must be aware and remain respectful to that other person. You could say, I know how much reaching this goal means to you and that you will be busy for another few months, but I will be here to support you. And number three is say your piece and release. So you suggest committing to a couple of small pockets of time daily that you two can connect so that you can still feel connected to one another during this busy time. You suggest maybe having dinner together completely uninterrupted, phones and laptop, everything away, where you guys can just talk about your day, what's going on, and enjoy a meal together. And you would also like to spend reading at the end of the day together on the couch for about 10 minutes at night. And however way your partner or the other person responds, you can take it with grace, but also recognize that you have the right to express your reactions as well. But doing so in a respectful and mindful, empathetic way, as we did in the second step. After hearing your suggestion, your partner has partly agreed to it. So they have been grabbing dinner on the way back from work so that they can continue to work once they get home. But they understand and recognize how quality time together is important to you and it's important to them because the relationship is a priority. So they will commit to 10-minute nightly reads together on the couch, only on the nights that they aren't working late. And you express disappointment in the partial agreement, but you appreciate them hearing you out and trying to work some sort of solution to the issue at hand. And so once you put it all on the table and you decided a way to move forward, once you have put it out there, it is time for you to release it into the wild, to let it go. Let it go, let it go. So yeah, no more passive aggressiveness. We are not holding on to how this person, your partner, has ignored you for 2 months and it'll come up in an argument a year later down the road. It is water under the bridge at this point. You are moving forward for the betterment of yourself and your peace of mind, and also for the quality of the relationship that you're trying to build. And if you want to try to find ways to fill in the gaps for dinner time, you can go over to a friend's place or a family's place to fill that void in the meantime. I think the important thing about disagreements or not having the same opinion as the other person is going into this conflict, this confrontation, going into it not thinking that this person is all wrong, they need to hear your side, all or nothing sort of deal. Because if you think that way, how likely is it for that person to try and understand where you're coming from and try to work in agreement with you? Chances are pretty slim. But also know that your feelings are valid and worth being expressed. But you must do so with respect and with dignity. Try not to focus on the hurt and the discomfort that this disagreement has had on you, but rather try to come to it being solution focused, trying to move forward, because that's the best thing that we can do in our lives. Always move forward. So it's time for me to wrap up this video because I decided to not use lights. Natural lighting has been really great the past few days because it's been really sunny in the Pacific Northwest, but we're about to lose it. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that bell. Before you hit the bell, hit the subscribe with the bell notification. It's not like you've done this about 40 times, Nicole. You should have this down by now so that you don't miss any future videos. And if you like this, you will probably like my The Dangers of Emotional Dumping and How to Vent Effectively video, which I will link up above. Up above. Words are hard sometimes. Anyways, that's it. Hope you liked it, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.